have to go way in there. See there. Hello.
Anything else? It is indeed a good afternoon to come and celebrate. It's always a joy to celebrate, no matter what the weather outside. It's a joy to celebrate 65 years of growing in the faith, growing in the Lord. It gives me so much pleasure today to see all the little ones and the entire parish here with us to celebrate our founding of this parish on this feast of Christ the King. Let us then begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters in the Lord, peace be with you.
And also with you.
Coming together this afternoon as God's parish family, the parish family of Saints Peter and Paul, let us ask God's forgiveness for our sins. Lord Jesus, you are the faithful witness testifying to the truth. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the King of glory, whose dominion is everlasting. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Lord of the Church, cleansing us in your blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Our first reading this afternoon for the feast celebrating Christ the King is taken from the Old Testament book of the prophet Daniel. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, he received dominion, glory, and kingship. Nations and peoples of every language serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
is with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to our brother John.
Glory to you, Lord.
And Pilate said to Jesus, "Are you the King of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Are you saying this on your own, or have others been telling you about me?" "I am no Jew," Pilate retorted. "It is your people and the chief priests who have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom were of this world, my subjects would be fighting to save me from being handed over to the Jews. As it is, my kingdom is not here." At this, Pilate said to him, "So then you are a king." Jesus answered, "It is you who say I am a king. The reason I was born, the reason why I came into the world is to testify to the truth. Anyone committed to the truth hears my voice." And this, my fellow Christians, is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear family of God, the reason why I came into the world is to testify to the truth. Jesus just said these words to us in the gospel this afternoon. Why am I born? Why am I living? What can I get? What am I giving? These lines from an old torture song of years ago ask all the right questions. We can ask those questions about our own life and about the life of our parish, Saints Peter and Paul. All of us want to make a success story of our lives. Just as this parish, founded 65 years ago, wanted it to be a success in the life of faith they lived and the drawing of people closer to God. Why was St. Peter and Paul founded? Why is it existing? What is the goal of this parish? Today's gospel text, Jesus announces his goal of his earthly life and our own lives in one very brief sentence. The reason why I came into the world is to testify to the truth. Jesus came into this world, my dear friends, to tell the truth. Nothing else. To tell the truth. To tell the truth about ourselves, to tell us who we are, where we came from, where we are going, to teach us to understand the truth about our life's goal, which is the kingdom of God, known to us by truth. And isn't that what Saints Peter and Paul have been about for the last 65 years? It's been involved in building the kingdom of God and preaching and living the truth in this west side of Detroit. Throughout these years, 65 years, the priests, the sisters, the faithful have been busy with living out Christ's love in Christ's death. Jesus tells us, anyone committed to the truth knows my voice, hears my voice. And to enrich our understanding of God's kingdom here among us, the first truth we must secure firmly in our hearts is that we come. You and I come. The parish comes. And all the people of this parish come. We matter. We are somebody. Each parishioner is a unique masterpiece of the divine arts, because this God willed us into being. He willed this parish into being. Each of us individually and as a parish is essential to God's plan. To know the truth, my dear friends, of our life's meaning, our life's purpose, we must recognize the truth, first of all, and basically, that you and I are worthwhile. The parish indeed is worthwhile. And to imagine a world without you, without me, without Saints Peter and Paul, is to imagine a different world that God has not in mind. If you would be true to your life's goal, if the parish is true to its life goal, then we must recognize, my dear friends, in ourselves, must recognize for the one-of-a-kind, irreplaceable, priceless gem of God's creation that we are. Now, all of this may sound basic and old-hat, but it is no less true that we find it difficult to accept this reality that we are individuals. We spend our time so often, trying to be someone else. The reason keeping up with the Joneses jokes aren't funny anymore is because everyone is trying to do it. Everyone is trying to keep up with the Joneses. Everyone is trying to bend to the pressure, the pressure's out there, the pressure to be truly successful in our modern society. We look at our TV ads and we see what successful people are like. It's to sell, it's advertising. And we gullibly fall for these pressures. And in doing so, we underestimate, my dear friends, our own true worth. We were born, my dear friends, to achieve far more nobler goals. And this is evident in the meaning of our Lord's words today in the Gospel. My kingdom belongs not to this world. This world is a means. This parish is a means by which you and I make our journey of faith to the kingdom. As individuals and as a parish, we are citizens of two worlds, the world of time and the world of eternity. It's not a matter of dividing loyalties, it's not that. It's rather a question in our lives of what is our highest loyalty, our highest priorities. We are born into both worlds. We are born to seek first the kingdom of God as individuals and as this parish of Saints Peter and Paul. use of this world as a means by which we come to God our Father as members of Saints Peter and Paul, and through this parish, we make our way to God. Why was I born? For the kingdom of God. Why am I living? For the kingdom of God. What can I get? The kingdom of God. What am I giving? That, my dear friends, is the ultimate question. What am I giving of my life? The answer to the question why we are born, why we are living, where we are going, our true work, our true goal, points towards the answer of what am I giving of my life to the Lord. Jesus came, my dear friends, to testify to the truth. Jesus tells us how to live by telling us what our lives are leading up to. And he has provided us with a punch ending, we all know, a tremendous life of the kingdom that he has made known to us already in order that we can deal with the events that happen to us along the way. Jesus' testimony this morning, this today, unravels the mystery of the kingdom, of God's kingdom. And what is that kingdom? It's a kingdom of God's love. We are those pearls, my dear friends, beyond the price. Why are we those pearls? Because God has loved us first. Oh, he has loved us. And for this reason, because God has loved us first as individuals and as a parish, because we know our worth, we who are loved, we love ourselves. That's a good idea, to love yourself. Because if you don't love yourself, you cannot love others. And for the same reason, because God has first loved every last human being born into this world, that is our impulse, our lesson to the Father, to love our neighbors as God has loved them first. In the fourth chapter of Mark, Jesus says to his apostles, "To you the mystery of the kingdom of God has been confided." Jesus gave himself for us because he gave himself totally in that supreme act of love on the cross. The mystery of the kingdom of God is made known to us, my dear friends. In all these 65 years, this was the work of the church here in Peter and Paul, to make known the mystery of God among you, the King among you. We begin to recognize then the worth of each individual who makes up this parish. God loves us, my dear friends, and he counts us worthy to have been born for his kingdom, each one of us without exception. What am I giving of my life? Where are we giving of our life? Do we recognize our brothers and sisters as objects of God's love? Do we as a parish share the Father's regard for our brothers and sisters as worthy subjects in the coming kingdom? If we answer yes to that, we'll know that we are giving ourselves as a living testimony, as a living example to the truth. And Jesus has come to tell us, and now it's our turn, following in his footsteps, to tell the truth that this world is loved by the Father. And we as a parish will be seen by others as the sign God's kingdom, if we tell the truth, God. God's love for us, for each other. Today, as we celebrate 65 years of knowing the Lord, may we continue, my dear friends, as our early pioneers, to struggle sometimes in good times and bad times, in times of joy, in times of sorrow, a struggle always to tell the truth that we are loved by God Himself. May God be with you.
consoled spiritually by the gifts of grace, and receive care and loving concern from family, friends, and neighbors, and financial help through the Campaign for Human Development, let us pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For ourselves, that we may recognize the kingship of Christ, who deserves to reign in our hearts and lives, let us pray to the
Lord. Hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives, friends, benefactors, and parishioners of Saints Peter and Paul, particularly Zofie Pasternak, Leo Chilorovich, and Mary Goshtua, who died this past week, that they may attain the blessedness of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For Bernard Desjardins and for Joseph Aiello and Santa Trupiano, whom we especially remember in the intentions of this Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, we thank you for gathering us today to celebrate. To celebrate years of toil and faith, years of growing to know you. We ask you to bless those present here today. Bless all our parishioners, that we may truly know the truth of your love for us. Bless future generations who will worship in this church, that they truly may also know the Lord in his goodness and his love for them. And listen to all the prayers we make to you today, for make them through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Just a reminder, today's second collection after communion will be for the Campaign for Human Development. We ask you to please be generous in your contributions to help the needy. Thank you.
Oh,
sacrifice today may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of our hands and knees, for the praise of the Lord, our King, for our good and the glory of His
Church. Lord, we offer you the sacrifice by which your Son reconciles mankind. May it bring unity and peace to the world. And we ask you this through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heart.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Sacrifice of peace. As King, he claims dominion over all creation, that he may present to you, his Almighty Father, a universal and eternal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and light, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and so with all the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Thou art power and might.
Thank you.
We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve. May all of us who share in the body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit.
Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love together with John Paul, our Pope, Edmund, our Cardinal Archbishop, all the clergy and all in service to your people.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to the rest in the hope of rising again. Bring us and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us willing to share our life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Sins and weaknesses, but on the faith and strength of your church, and grant us kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
Let's now reach out with a sign of peace.
We have just three announcements for this week. On Thursday, we will observe Thanksgiving Day. Masses will be celebrated at 7 p.m. on Wednesday, and then at 9 a.m. on Thursday. All who attend either Mass are asked to bring a donation of foodstuff for the needy of our parish. The Dance Club is sponsoring a pinochle night next Saturday at 7 p.m. in the school hall. Christmas wafers, or fakki, are available from the ushers after Masses on this weekend and at room 105 of the school during the week, Monday through Friday, 8 until 5, except, of course, on Thanksgiving Day. Thank you very much for your kind attention and have a good week.
Please be seated. I'd like to take this occasion to express my very, very sincere thanks to our school children, our scouting units, to our youth group, to all the societies, guilds, and groups here at St. Peter and Paul. Of course, to our parish council, commissions, to all of you that come to make this Mass a very special Mass in the history of our parish. We thank you all for coming today. We thank the choir, Mr. Chris Bisunia, for supplying the inspiring music this afternoon. I hope that this Mass has helped us to grow in faith, has helped us to know the truth that God loves us. If we take anything else back with us today out of this church, it's this, that God loves you in a very special way. I'd like to extend on behalf of Cardinal Shaka, who cannot be here today. He has confirmations at the cathedral, and greetings from our local bishop, Bishop Anderson, who was in Rome for the canonization of Mother Drexel. They extend to you, to all of us, sincere greetings on this day, and they pray that God may continue to bless the parish of St. Peter and Paul with faith. And this church may always proclaim the gospel in its entirety and its vigor. May God be with you.
Let us pray. Lord, you give us Christ, the King of our creation, as one for everlasting life. Help us to live by his gospel and bring us to the joy of his kingdom, where he lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And also with you.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace now to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thank you, God.
Thank you.
We said we had to have some ideas.
How are you?